Hey Alicia, how are you doing?
Hi, you're here for the makeup, yeah?
Hi.
Oh, fantastic. Halloween,
yeah.
Are you okay just to be what? About? I do have someone just to do the makeup just now.
Okay.
Are you okay just to wait for a minute or two?
Yeah, it's fine, yeah, no worries.
Fantastic, if you want to come and
thanks very much. Ah, Johnny.
Hello.
What are you doing here?
I don't know, mate. What are you doing here?
Wait,
I thought you were supposed to be away.
Well, I'm here because I'm going to pull a fucking prank on the Lotties from the Burger and Keg open mic. Currently, right now, Graham Kerr is hosting the open mic night. I'm here with Alicia and Martin. Mm-hmm. We're going to do me up a little bit, make myself look a bit different. And I'm going to come down and cause a bit of mayhem.
Oh, I've got a name for my character.
Let me hear.
Div Campbell, you'll remember this. This is Alan Patterson, Al is going to be our man tonight. Maybe doing like an Edinburgh accent, so I need to kind of work out my location. But I don't know if I can do like an Edinburgh accent, eh? Hello, Paul. My name's Alan Patterson and I'm from Edinburgh, eh? Is this an open mic night you've got here? I'd like to do a tune or two if that's alright with you. Dinky do Scotty McClue. I don't know. Believable? Not. Gonna be this arsehole old man.
Yes. Just start telling people about your 18 grandkids.
Yeah, cool. 18, I was thinking 22. You hadn't seen my Facebook post, that whole post where I was dressed as Top Gun, saying I'm dressed as Top Gun for tonight. That was a bit of a diversion there.
Looked like before.
I know.
That's what I need.
Why are you putting a spin in your mouth?
So I can get it down so it looks sagging. So basically when that comes out, it's going to look like it's kind of sagged a wee bit, so it's like it's aged.
Class. Maybe I should just keep the spin all night. Oh, Paterson, I had a serious accident when I was 22 years old with a fucking spin. Hello, I'm Alan Paterson, eh? What's your name, Paul? Do you play a trombone?
This is real human hair. It's called a facial prosthesis.
It's real human hair?
Yep.
It's real human pubes that I'm getting put onto my face. It's
you know the donor?
Oh, it's my da, Arthur Paterson.
We're gonna have this all over your face like that. Does it feel like pubes? Does it feel
yeah.
Pubes? Does it
feel yeah. Pubes? It's like Saturday night all over again.
How do you feel?
Like a real man.
Wee bonnet for my great uncle. My great uncle Patrick or Eric for no less.
Are you like totally in disguise now?
What, it's probably going to be heaving. I've said to keep the lights low. Like not just normally while you're going to put light in. Like the smoke machine's going to be on. Busy. Oh. So, like I'll just be able to walk in.
I'll show you this one.
So what do you think you'll order when you go in?
Well, I'd like a pint of Tennent's, you know, nothing like a good pint of Tennent's. From what I hear, they don't serve fucking Tennent's. Jokes. So it'll be a soak only. Lemonade. A wee dram.
A wee glaring morange.
Aye,
that's it. Glen morange. Glen morange. Be a right dick right now and go, it's
actually Glen morange. Oh, what the fuck, no! Bet if Alec said that. Or do you mean Glen morange, hen?
Yeah. So right now I'm just using some Brazil. This is like cream paint, and what we're doing is we're putting it underneath the eye. So if you were looking at the camera there, Johnny, you'll see that he looks like he has been through some shit.
Story of my life.
I can see this like huge differences, but like I still think shit is me. Like, do you know what I mean? It's like paranoid, but just need to just go over it.
How old are you?
54 year old, Paul.
62.
62, eh?
62.
62. 62, looking good for 62.
Yeah, I passed up two girls and they knew who I was.
Oh, did they now? What do you mean?
No, as in they recognise who I'm dressed up as.
Well, two random girls?
Yeah, they recognise who I'm dressed up as.
Are you dressed up as me?
No.
Alright, so that was a bit of vain, wasn't it?
What?
It's a bit vain by Alec there. Alec's a bit vain.
Sorry, I'm just late for an open mic, yeah? Sorry. I'm in a... Oh my god.
straight through to the bedroom there.
Where am I going? I'm in a rush to the other.
Oh my god!
I'm in a rush.
I told you that's what you
were doing. Here you
go.
Oh my god!
I told you
that. And I gave myself a beard and all.
That is amazing!
Look, I even gave myself a belly and all.
So you think I should wear a wig? Because I don't know, I just think wigs are obvious.
Well, you don't. See, without, take a wig off for a second.
Yeah, I'm not sure you should wear that wig if you're trying to look.
Alright guys, I'm off to my open mic. Gonna have to let Graham down that I'm there. I'm gonna sing Brother. I'm gonna sing a bit of that, what's that, Raptive, whatever song called. And, you know, I'm just gonna go on and be like, what's the story, lads? I'm Johnny Barr. The one and only Johnny Barr. Alright guys, see you later.
That's exactly what you need to do, is just, yep.
Alright, Paul. Hey, yeah, he's a wee fucking pint of tenants.
Oh, see,
I'll meet your knight.
Men are strong.
I can see.
Is it going to hurt your eyes?
I can do that, probably.
Because you're more than welcome to wear my glasses. Cause
drink it.
Do the glasses help?
I would say definitely.
I mean, even if I just sit like that, I could just sit like that.
Because it makes them, I think it makes them.
Oh, shit, I don't put the eyes in, I actually forgot about that. I didn't know how I'm going to do that. I've never put contacts in.
The hand that they're most comfortable with, if you're right handed or left handed, then you would use that hand to put the lens on. The other hand is going to come up over your head and grab your eyelashes to get them out of the way.
Nah, fuck this, man. Alright, Paul. I'm Alec Patterson. I'm here to cause fucking terror to the Paisley Open mic scene. So I hope you're fucking ready, pals. Oh, yes!
Think of this place.
You know,
what
he's
good, right, cool. You ready to go on the road?
Aye.
Right, cool.
I'm not ready yet, you know. Aye, cool. I need ball.
The shite, this old mic, aren't it? You better get up and fucking show them where it's done, eh?
You can play like at the same time, like whatever.
jumping the fucking up, mug with the mug. I don't know if there's someone.
The script here, boys.
So, how is it for you, Jarvis? Did you fall for the prank tonight?
I really fell for it, man. Like, he came up to me, he's like, who's that guy singing, man? Who's that guy? I was like, that's my pal Graham. He's like, That guy's crap, man. That guy's crap, man. I could do better than him. I'll show these guys off.
And do you know what?
I'll show these guys off. But it was Johnny Barr on it all the time, man.
One thing that I've got to respect him for, like, one of the things we have in our night is everyone's welcome on the stage. You should always love everyone that's on and appreciate. I was doing that exact opposite, and do you know what? He was turning like, mate, you're being out of order. Like, honestly, fuck off. Like, you're being out of order.
Aye.
So he respected the code of the Paisley Open mic at the Burger Keg. So. Nice one, dude. But absolutely everything you said, I was like, yes, you're following this so bad. It was like so good.
I can't believe that, man. I cannot believe.
I know.
Honestly, you've done a fucking good job with this, man.
I know,
honestly,
I'm happy. But anyway.
This is class, by the way.
That's actually
class, by the way. What are you? Something that I fucking know.
It's a fucking old bastard.
Over twist, man. Over twist.
Yeah, Johnny came in on incognito tonight, and I was sitting on the cajon, and as soon as I walked in, I just was like that. There's Johnny, straight away. I know Johnny, me and Johnny are really good mates, so I could spot my mile away, but I played along for the sake of it, but it was a good night, a good idea, and I think you get away with it. So cool, well done, Johnny. And also, thanks for upstaging me, covering Europe and Mike. Tadger.
How did it feel to be Johnny Barr tonight?
Oh, well, I got the praise and all that stuff. The only thing I'm gutted about is I didn't even win best costume because I should.